Hello VSDC family, we are thrilled to announce that the new 9.3 update VSDC is out. If you want to learn more about all its new features, you're in the right place. Let's jump in. Text conversion tool. The first feature we want to introduce is the text conversion tool, designed for transforming text to free shapes, curved lines, tracking points, and text blocks. How does it work? Simple. Start with adding a text object of the desired size using the vertical left panel. Type or paste your text there and press Escape to remove the blinking text cursor. Next, right-click on the text object on the scene or timeline and select the New Convert Text To option. A drop-down list will appear allowing you to choose one of four modes of text conversion. The first mode is Free Shape. In its settings window, you can leave the parameters by default. The text conversion will give you a good result anyway, or you can change them. For instance, you can split your text by characters, words, or sentences. If you choose words in the Split By parameter of this window, each word of your text will be converted into a separate free shape. In the same window, you can also apply fade-in and fade-out effects, as well as transitions for your text. Next up, we have the curve line mode. In this mode, your text is split into curve lines for creating quick animations, for example, text outline animation. Just like with free shapes, you can stick with the default settings for an impressive effect right away or tweak the parameters for a smoother, more fluid appearance of your text as it fades in and out. Now, let's move to the third mode, tracking points, where you can apply lens flare or bokeh glare effects in the effect parameter during the conversion stage. This can already yield stunning results. If you want, you can change the glare of this effect to any object, for example, to ellipses. We'll show you how to do it using one letter as an example. To scene 0, add the object you want the contour to be traced with. Now make sure that your text layer is visible and then go inside it. After that, inside any of the lens flare or bokeh glare objects. Double-click on the tracking point here and find the movement layer. Copy and paste it into the object you created. That's it. Now you see that this object is tracing the outline of the letter. And the last mode, the text blocks, that allows you to quickly split text into words, characters, or sentences. If you choose, for example, words, these transitions will create text layers with each word and you can automatically apply transition effects to each element, just like with free shapes. New ready-made templates. The next thing we want to share with you is the new addition to our template collection. 9 wedding slideshow templates, effortlessly customizable with your own photos and videos. LUTs, organized into 5 separate packs. And 10 text templates, in which you can modify the text, shape, and color to suit your style. You You can purchase each set of templates individually by right-clicking on any template in the desired collection and selecting Purchase Template in the drop-down list. You'll then be redirected to the checkout window where you need to complete the billing information questionnaire and proceed to buy the entire pack. Wizard Enhancement. Great news about our slideshow window. The wizard's interface has been completely redesigned, making it more powerful and user-friendly. You can now access the entire library of available transitions, use new buttons in the preview window for quick navigation and instant viewing of your results, and many more for your efficient workflow. Fill background function. Have you ever struggled to fill in black bars by duplicating and blurring the object you're editing? Now you have the ability to quickly fill these empty spaces when they don't match the scene size. For instance, if you want to insert a horizontal video into a vertical project, simply select Fill Background, Blur Background in its Properties window. Here you can also adjust the blur levels and the opacity of the color overlay. If needed, you can also customize the position of the background image for a perfect fit. Just a few clicks and you have the result without any effort. Auto-detect sprite parameters. Some of you asked us why we don't set no for use as a container and yes for show effects by default, because in almost every video tutorial we ask you to do it manually. So we've made a change to the sprite properties, and now it automatically displays effects when they're directly inside the sprite. This enhancement saves you time, and you won't need to adjust these settings in the sprite properties anymore. However, we've retained the option to use the sprite as a container, as this feature can be essential for some of your projects. More user-friendly functionality. As you may have noticed, the properties window now features toggles instead of the traditional yes and no options. For some effects, these toggles impact the key editor. For example, let's take a closer look at the segmentation effect, where you can now set key points for the visibility of a region using a key point and a toggle, allowing for more precise adjustments. We've also enhanced the precision for effects such as scale, rotation, perspective, and skew, giving you greater control over the effect parameters. Additionally, color circles have been improved. You no longer need to move the cursor to the center of the circle. Simply click and hold the left mouse button within the circle area. For those who enjoy customizing their workspaces, the new update allows you to save and use an unlimited number of workspace configurations, whereas previously only a few presets were available. Moreover, the program now remembers your last selection in the template window and the file extension in the Explorer window, streamlining navigation and saving you time. The template search algorithm has also been improved, making it easier to find any effect with all folder contents displayed by default. In addition to these enhancements, we've made numerous smaller changes aimed at improving your overall experience and have fixed many bugs you reported. Try all the new features right now. Download the new 9.3 version of VSDC from the link in the description or the pinned comment. That's it for now. Do not forget to subscribe to our channel, because in an upcoming video, we'll take a closer look to our new text conversion tool, exploring all its capabilities. See you next time!